Okay, so, problem number one, glass. Did you see it?
No.
Okay, I did. One sentence summary. M. Night, you know who I mean.
M. Night.
That's the one. Ties Unbreakable and Split in a film that asks if Bruce Willis and Sam Jackson and James McAvoy are actually magic, or are they just mad? They're mad. Could you be the villain? Yes, I could.
Who's the villain?
Good question, Brad.
I don't know who's the villain in this film.
I'm about to say.
I've seen Unbreakable and Bruce Willis double R. So
he's more than double R.
Yeah. So he's a villain.
So in the villain of Glass, Dr. Staple, I think it's Dr. Eddie Staple, is a psychiatrist who's trying to convince all the three characters that they're not actually magic, they're just like special and mad.
Right.
Turns out, spoiler alert, should have mentioned this before, she's part of an organisation that have been trying. Yeah, Dream, so it's a woman doctor, very odd. But she is part of an organisation that has been suppressing super people for, and I quote, 10,000 years. So this is, you know, it's a long time. So my fan theory that I came up with, I haven't looked it up, and might be other people. Jesus was one of those people that she killed.
Okay.
Okay. Anyway, so they've got special rooms to defeat Bruce Willis because he's afraid of water, and James McAvoy doesn't like special flashing lights, apparently. But she's no match for Sam Devious Jackson, because he's just a smart guy. He outwits her, and I feel that in the same situation I could do so. Or, I just use my brute physical strength to knock her the fuck out. And how would I improve the film? Now, I ruined this for a bit for Darren earlier, but obviously Mark saw it and Hutch saw it, and that, I saw him in the car park. I'm actually in the same screening. Fun little story there. But how would I be the bit? How would I improve the film? Bruce Willis goes out like a little bitch. Like he gets drowned in the puddle by a dude that we don't really see on camera. So why have made it like a heroic sacrifice that he chooses, that he knows he's going to die, but he does it anyway?
Yeah.
Because that's more heroic. Also, M. Night Shyamalan has a cameo that goes on for like 5 straight minutes.
It's not a cameo.
No, it's not. It takes you out of the film. It's very distracting.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, Bruce Willis's character, didn't you used to work at the like stadium? He's like, yes, I did. He's like, oh, cool. I used to hang around at the stadium back when I was younger, but now I've sorted my life out and I'm going to get some cameras for a building I own. Cut all that, just have him as a character in the background. Fucking
yeah.
God damn.
Like Stan Lee.
Right, like Stan Lee or Alfred Hitchcock used to do it, it's just like maybe sometimes a silhouette. It was all good. So what would I rate this film out of 5 beers?
Yeah.
4.5 beers, you don't need to be paying attention. You could be borderline unconscious, borderline pissing yourself. Holmes and Watson. Did you see it?
No.
I did. Okay. One sentence summary. John C. Reilly, Watson, is sick of being in Will Ferrell's shadow, Holmes, and just must prove himself as an equal co-detective.
Yeah.
There might have been some subtext there. One sentence summary. Mrs. Hudson turns out to be the villain in the film, spoiler alert. She's doing it to impress her dad, who is Moriarty, who is not old enough to be her dad in the film. But Darren, as you know, I can handle ladies with daddies.
Yeah.
It's fine. How would I improve the film? Work on the accents. John C. Reilly, spot on with his accent.
What, English accent?
Yes. Will Ferrell needed some work. John C. Reilly, better in the film than Will Ferrell. I'm going to say that.
That's fine. Okay.
I'll also fix the time though, because old Albert Einstein, who was in the same era as Marilyn Monroe, does not deserve to be in the same timeline in as Queen Victoria and the Titanic, unless it's a film about time travel. Let's sort it out! Alright! Also cut out a song, that was shit. And
what song is that?
Will Ferrell sang a song about how he loved it, except his feelings. Yeah.
Okay.
Vice. Did you see it?
No.
Okay. One sentence summary. Christian Bale puts on a load of weight to play Dick Cheney in a sort of biopic. Could you be the villain? So, weirdly enough, the villain in this film...
Trump.
He was featured in it, yeah. And there was a bit where Reagan said, let's make America great again. Obviously Trump copied that because he's a twat. But the villain in the film was Cheney.
Right.
Who was like Bush's second in command, sort of thing.
Yeah.
And his only antagonist in like a story writing sense was the people who wouldn't elect him, so he could do all the shit he wanted.
Right.
So could I beat him? Really, it depends on the situation. If it was a street fight, yeah, I'd take him out. Political battle, maybe not. He's got the experience.
Yeah.
If I were to take him out, I would have to make sure his whole family dies. Because a lot of them, like his wife and his, I think it was his oldest daughter, seem very, very similar to him, very cutthroat.
Right.
So if they live, they'd probably bomb the UK. Just like those people did to Iraq. Right?
Oh, direct correlation.
Yeah. Last film, 5 beers out of 5, don't care. This film, 2 beers out of 5, you've got to pay a bit of attention.
Okay.
Yeah. Final film, Escape Room.
Did you see it?
Okay. One sentence summary. People with tragic backstories try to escape from rooms. What would I change? I change it to escape rooms. That just makes sense. Yeah, one sentence summary, blah blah blah. Could I beat the villain? Yeah. We did an escape room, didn't we?
Yeah.
So what depends on the film, would I be willing to sacrifice the people I was with?
Yes, I would.
That's a simple answer. And then the hunters become the prey.
Okay, the hunters become the hunters. Hunters become the hunters.
Yeah. How would I improve the film?
By not making it.
No, it was pretty good actually. How would I improve it? There was a creepy security guard at the front. Or at the start of the film.
Yeah.
You've got a lot of good Deborah Ann Wolfe.
Right.
She's an actress in it. And she's ginger. Right. But like, I'd have made him like at the end. Like, oh, he's the villain. I'd have made him that guy.
Yeah.
Because in the actual film, he was just a weird guy that appeared one time and then didn't get it brought up again. Yeah. 3 out of 5. 3. So yeah, that's what happened in January. That's half our film reviews, and...
Yeah, I mean, I've slacked you, so I haven't seen anything.